Going into their final round of the season 2 points ahead of YMCA and with a superior goal difference, Victoria Park realistically only needed a draw. Three times they led UWA, but were pegged back each time before two goals in the last 5 minutes from Stephen Boyce and Daniel Timms cost them a spot in the finals. UWA finished at the summit of the Premier League, again winning their last 8 games in a row. Last year's grand final winners, Wasps, also found themselves in the hunt to defend their title after finishing third, despite going down 3-0 to Old Aquinians in round 21. Aaron Zalewski found the net twice either side of teammate Ben Wright's second-half field goal. However, despite the impressive victory, it ultimately proved to be too little too late for Reds to make finals. Elsewhere, Hale cemented second spot with a game to spare after defeating Victoria Park 5-1. Liam Flynn hit a hat-trick, while Alec Rasmussen and Jeff Cock were also on target. 4 more goals in Hale's 5-3 win over Curtin University in round 22 ensured that Liam Flynn finished as the league's top goal scorer on 26, 4 clear of Wasps' Trent Mitten. North Coast Raiders turned in a spirited performance against YMCA in round 20, but remained winless after going down 4-3. Goals from Darren Morton initially gave Raiders the lead, but a Jai Connolly hat-trick and a Christopher Lim effort ensured that Reece Burnich's second-half strikes were ultimately in vain. Raiders went on to finish the season without a win. While it meant that YMCA capitalised on Vic Park's final day defeat to sneak into fifth place with a 4-0 win over Melville. Jai Connolly struck twice to take his tally to 19 and finish as the league's third highest scorer. At the bottom of the table, Melville's win over Guildford in the penultimate round of the season proved invaluable in the race to avoid the drop. First-half strikes from Kyle McNess and Matt Willis put Melville in the driving seat, but Chris Cirriello pulled one back midway through the second half to give his side hope. However, in the 56th minute, Melville's Matt Willis found the target again, and despite William Battistessa scoring in the closing seconds, it was Melville's day. The win confined Guildford to the relegation playoffs and ensured Melville would finish safe for another year. Fremantle kept their finals hopes alive with a resounding 5-1 win over North Coast Raiders in round 21 and followed it up with a hard-fought win over Wolves in their final game. The result ensured that the Magpies finished fourth, having won 3 of their last 4 games. Elsewhere, Westside Wolves and Curtin University avoided a nervy end to the year by ensuring their safety ahead of time. Victories over Guildford and Raiders helped Wolves to safety, while Curtin University were bolstered by win against Frio and draw against Raiders.
I'd probably pick out one, but it was pretty funny play against Rob, who was assistant coach at the time. That was quite interesting. Also growing up, I idolised Rob quite a bit, so playing that centre half role that I play at the moment, I thought, you know, you just want to try a little bit harder against those type of guys.
I usually have 3 games left with the relegation series, so it's a bit different this year. It's good. I'm not sure what I'm going to do this September.
We have a good mix of youth and experience with a few former Kookaburras like Devo and Guesty, and then a lot of junior rep players, so it's a really good mix.